All right, welcome to The Explainer. Today, we're going to pull back the curtain on a really core economic idea, and we're taking our cues from a series of academic lectures by Michael Revive to really get to the bottom of the hidden forces that drive every single purchase you make.
You know, for most of us, it's the price tag, right? That's the first thing we zero in on. And as it turns out, economists have this, well, this brilliantly simple way to actually visualize how that price is pulling the strings on our decisions. Okay, so let's jump right in. The whole idea really comes down to this one powerful tool that economists use to basically map out our collective desires. And that tool is called the demand curve. Let's use a really simple example to see how this works. I mean, just look at this table here. The relationship is super intuitive, right? The more something costs, the less of it people want to buy. So if something is priced at, say, 40 bucks, you might only buy 2 of them. But hey, if that price plummets to 10, suddenly you might grab 20. This simple little chart, the one that just lays out prices and how much people want at those prices, well, that's what economists call a demand schedule.
Okay, so what happens if we take those numbers from the table and actually plot them on a graph? Well, that's when we get what's called the demand curve. And it's a really simple but incredibly powerful visual. Seriously, just picture a line that slopes downwards from left to right. That's it. It perfectly shows that fundamental rule of economics. As the price of something drops, the amount people want to buy goes up.
All right, so we have this curve, but how does it actually help us understand our own behavior? Well, let's start with the most obvious thing that can happen. The price changes. So if the price of a product changes, and this is key, only the price changes, all we do is move from one point to another along that same exact curve. See, this isn't about you suddenly wanting the product more or less in general. No, it's just a direct, knee-jerk reaction to a new price. A big sale starts, bam, you move down the curve and buy more. The price goes up for some reason, you just slide right back up the curve and buy less. It's that simple.
But what happens when something else changes? Something that isn't the price? Like, what if you get a big raise at work? Or a new fashion trend makes something super popular all of a sudden? Now, this is where it gets really, really fascinating. Because the entire curve itself can actually move.
And here it is, the key difference in a nutshell. A movement along the curve is just you dancing with the price tag. The price goes up, you take a step back. The price goes down, you step forward. But a shift of the entire curve, that's a whole different story. That means the music has changed. It's a fundamental change in how much you want that product, no matter what the price tag says.
So what are these outside factors? What are these things that can just pick up the whole curve and move it? Well, economists have a name for them, of course. They call them shifters. And you can think of them as the invisible forces that are guiding our choices when the price tag isn't the only thing we're looking at.
And here are some of the heavy hitters, the most common shifters out there. We're talking about things like your income changing, or the price of other related goods. Like, think about it. If the price of coffee suddenly skyrockets, your demand for tea, which is what we call a substitute good, might go way up, even if the price of tea didn't budge an inch. So a change in any one of these can totally change your buying habits.
Okay, to make this really concrete, let's talk about something pretty much everyone can get behind. Chocolate. So imagine you get a nice raise at work. Your income suddenly goes up. What do you think happens to your demand for a little chocolatey treat?
Well, in the world of economics, chocolate is what we call a normal good. And don't let the jargon fool you, it's a really simple idea. It's just a formal way of saying it's the kind of thing people tend to buy more of when they have more money in their pocket. You know, stuff like going out for dinner more often, buying new clothes, or maybe finally booking that vacation.
So because your income went up, your fundamental desire for chocolate has actually increased. You're now willing to buy more chocolate at every single price. Whether a bar costs 15 bucks or 40 bucks, you're just buying more. See, you're not just moving along your old demand curve anymore. Your whole mindset, your whole situation has changed.
And what this looks like on the graph is that your entire demand curve for chocolate literally shifts outwards to the right. Just picture the old line and then a brand new line right next to it, a little further out. This new line, this new curve, shows that you're willing to buy more chocolate at every single price point. Now that is a true shift. It's not just a little slide along the old line.
Okay, so what's the big takeaway here? Why does this even matter? Why is it so important to know the difference between a simple movement along the curve and a fundamental shift of the whole thing?
Well, it really all comes down to this. Understanding the difference gives you a brand new lens to see your own economic choices. It helps you figure out when you're just reacting to a sale, you know, a simple price change, versus when your actual priorities, your life circumstances, have really truly changed.
So take a second and think about it.
what's the biggest shifter in your own life? Is it your income? Are your tastes changing as you get older? Or maybe it's the price of something else that you buy regularly. Seriously, thinking about this stuff isn't just some boring economic exercise. It's actually the key to becoming a smarter and way more conscious consumer.